Hi students, today we will be continuing with the second part of the second unit of crystal lattice and unit cells. When we consider cubic unit cells, there are certain parameters we do analyze. The parameters are derived with geometrical calculations, and these parameters are atomic radius, number of unit atoms per unit cell, coordination number and density of the unit cells. Let us begin with the first definition, atomic radius and relation between edge length. Remember the symbols used here. Atomic radius is denoted with R, edge length will be A, and distance between two nearest neighbor atoms will be denoted by D. Before we derive them, on this particular slide, we will see all the relations together. I will suggest to remember them by heart for all your exams. For simple cubic lattice, atomic radius is equal to edge length upon 2. Distance between nearest neighbor is equal to edge length itself. For body-centered cubic lattice, R is equal to root 3 upon 4 into edge length. Distance between nearest neighbor is root 3 into upon 2 multiplied by A. For face centered cubic lattice, radius is equal to 1 upon 2 root 2 into edge length. Distance between nearest neighbor is 1 upon root 2 multiplied by A. We will now shortly derive these relations, especially the first set of relations. First, let us see a derivation now with respect to different type of lattice. The first we are considering is simple cubic crystal. This particular diagram which we have seen, you can see here the radius is denoted by R and the edge length of the cube is A. With simple observation, anybody can see that radius 2 times will be equal to edge length. So the formula is edge length equal to 2 into radius, or radius equal to A upon 2. The second derivation we are doing is for body centered cubic. Watch the things very carefully. From the front face, we are considering radius of an atom. The right hand side face, edge length A is shown. Now we can understand, just like simple cube, we cannot simply add the radius because there is a gap in between atoms due to body centered atom. So we apply here now Pythagoras theorem. For first right hand side face, we will apply Pythagoras theorem as B square equal to A square plus A square. Now, applying Pythagoras for the remaining right-hand side triangle, it will be C square equal to A square plus B square. But according to earlier step, B square is 2A square. So now, C square equal to 3A square. Or taking square root, C equal to root 3A. We now substitute the value of root 3A as 4R. Now, how do we do that? Watch the line C completely. And you can see, part by part, it is made up of 4 radii. Starting from the left-hand side most bottom corner, go up to the end. Take 1 minute and check whether it really looks like 4 radii. First, left-hand side circle. Then entire body center will have 2 radii and the corner most. So that makes A as 4R upon root 3. Or if I write, R is equal to root 3 upon 4 into A. The next derivation is for face-centered cubic lattice. Here we have now radius as R, the edge length is A, and now for derivation purpose we are considering the right-hand side face, which is B. Here itself we can see B is equal to 4R. Or b square is equal to, using Pythagoras theorem, 2a square. So if I substitute b square as 16r square, it will be equal to 2a square, or a equal to root 8 upon into r. It can be even written as r equal to 1 upon 2 root 2 into a. We now come to the concept called atomic packing factor, also known by the term packing efficiency. To understand this, we have a simple formula. Atomic packing factor is volume of atoms in unit cell divided by what volume of unit cell. Let us use this formula for three different cases, one by one. First, consider a simple cubic or primitive cube. You can see in the diagram here that it contains totally one atom, and the radius just now we derived in the previous derivation as 0.5a, which means a upon 2. If I apply all these parameters in the upper formula, I will get atomic packing factor equal to 1, which is number of atoms, into 4 upon 3 pi r cube. Now, this is a formula we are using for the volume of sphere upon volume of unit cell is a, that is a cube. So, we can see the formula is divided in three parts. The first part in numerator is atoms per unit cell. Second part is volume per atom. Denominator is volume of the unit cell. When we substitute all the parameters in this, we get an answer 0.52, where the packing efficiency becomes 52.4%, void space remains 47.6%. Let us use now similar logic for body-centered cubic, where we had derived earlier that length is root 3 into a, or unit cell now contains 2 atoms per unit cell. So, the APF formula becomes 2 into 4 upon 3 pi r cube, where the r value is root 3a upon 4, volume is a cube. Calculating this, we get an answer 0.68, or packing efficiency becomes 68%. The void space remaining is 32%. Talking about APF of face-centered cubic, here the closed packing length is root 2 into a. There are 4 atoms per unit cell. So the formula becomes 4 into 4 upon 3 pi r cube, where radius value is root 2a upon 4 upon a cube. The APF value comes out to be 0.74. Packing efficiency is 74%. The void space is found to be 26%. If you compare all the values of packing efficiency, face-centered cubic has maximum efficiency and minimum empty space, void space. We come to the last part of these derivations, that is density of the unit cell. Now, this can be understood in very simple way. Density, as we know, is mass upon volume. And mass will be given as number of atoms per unit cell into mass of each atom. Mass of each atom is given by atomic weight upon Avogadro's number. Now, you think for a moment all the equations in a reverse way. The last equation can be substituted in the previous second equation, and second equation can be substituted in the first equation. We derive in this way: density equal to Z into M upon A cube into Avogadro number. What are the terms involved here? Z is the number of atoms in unit cell. If numerical problem says unit cell is simple cubic, take Z as 1. If numerical problem is body-centered cubic, take it as 2. And for face-centered cubic, take it as 4. Density is given by D, and a unit is in CGS system here, gram per centimeter cube. A cube is the volume, once again in CGS system, cm cube. Na is Avogadro number, and M is the atomic mass. Remember, most of the time these problems are solved in the CGS system itself. This completes our second unit of the topic known as crystallography and its calculations.